The world has changed, and the skill set that's going to be most important for the 21st century is not the same skill set as the one that we created in the 1950s.
Maybe the way to try to drive some change in engineering education is by actually starting a new college completely from scratch.
Olin's an engineering school where you understand that there's a fundamentally different definition of engineering. It's about deeply understanding the world and what it needs.
So the way to think of Olin is it's not actually a college, it's a form of national laboratory.
We have a lot less lecture and a lot less of the student sits here and the professor sits here and knowledge flows this direction.
Just sitting there watching someone draw stuff or write stuff on the board and you copy it down and you call it a day, it never quite works for me. We're trying to develop a fully autonomous robotic fish that is capable of crossing the Atlantic Ocean using a propulsion method that is entirely based on biological fish. I have to solve my own problems. I have to figure out what I need to know. I have to go find that knowledge and then apply it. It sticks around for a lot longer.
So rather than listening to how it could be done, you actually do it and experience it.
Before I came, the 50-50 split wasn't really a thing I realized I cared about. And then I got here and I realized how much I liked having other women around.
The entrepreneurial mindset really is threaded through the curriculum, and we've seen really successful student groups who have spun off a small company while they've been at Olin as they've left Olin.
Scope is our senior capstone project.
We bring in companies from outside with real problems, and then the Olin students examine the problem, come up with a solution. The companies love it. We have more companies knocking on our door than we can possibly fit in the program.
Employers tell us it's as if they have 3 to 5 years of experience when they leave, because they actually have 3 to 5 years of experience when they leave.
Senior executives require employability skills, digital fluency, and innovation science. And Olin students are graduating with those skills. It's truly differentiating.
The number of places our students go and the number of organizations that want them is, I think, all the evidence you need that we must be doing something right.
About 40% of Olin's alumni so far have continued on to graduate work. About 25% of the kids who continue on go to either Harvard, Stanford, or MIT. The National Academy of Engineering created a list of what they call the grand challenges, 14 problems that we will have to solve in order to continue life as we expected.
There are critical problems to solve. They have substantial technical components, but they also have really critical economic, political, social components. We have a large fraction of our students that are doing the Grand Challenge Scholars Program.
Both here in the United States and overseas, more and more people are looking at Olin as a model for the future.
Our job isn't just to come up with a new recipe to teach engineering, it's to give that recipe away to anybody who wants it.
At present, we probably have about 3 institutions visiting a week.
Schools like the University of Illinois, like the University of Texas at El Paso, like Delft University.
Olin is doing enormously powerful work with other institutions in the world. By investing in Olin, you're making a difference in education on a very broad scale.